So when you see both of these two individuals together at an event filming, you know that they're up to no good, as we see in the New York Occupied event. Every time that there was a situation at that event, you were sure to find either one of them or both of them standing in the background with the camera or the boom mic getting the footage. This we saw over and over again, and this also showed to me that these events were being staged. Now, what I didn't know until the other day was the fact that Cliff is none other than Kenny Bloomberg. The following clip was played by Russia Today, RT, on YouTube. See if you notice anything wrong with it. So as you watch this clip now, you angry? You mad? You think that the police are beating these kids for no reason at all? It would seem that way, wouldn't it? That's what RT wants you to think. Because they're trying to provoke you. Why? I don't know, but let me show you what the real clip looked like. And what they cut out of the beginning. So did you catch that? Just see what the guy did in the beginning. Here, watch it one more time. Now watches the punk in the beginning. Points up at the camera. Then tells the officers, go ahead, ready, start. And then they look around. They say, you ready? Alright, begin. Now, you didn't see that beginning. They cut it out. They only show you the part where the kid's hand was in the air, and then he put it down to his side. So you thought that they was unprovoked. Points up to the cameraman, right? Now. Tells the officer, yep, go ahead, start, we're filming. And then they begin. Totally staged. 100% staged. Now, who is that kid? Who are the officers, and who's taking instructions from who? Now let's go back to New York. Let's look and see about the pepper spray incident. See if there's anything there to say that it was staged. Did you catch the one in the gray shirt, what she was doing with her hand? Well, she's the protester that was topless that you'll see later on, and we'll talk about who she really is, but look at her hand this time. So she's pumping her finger up and down like she's spraying a bottle of mace. So she's given the sign that the scene is coming up to get over here to film it. And once again, here you can see her pumping her finger up and down like she's spraying a bottle.
Tell me what happened.
Wait, I'm standing right here with these guys.
Yeah.
Whatever, tablets.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to stay off the sidewalk because I know they don't want the sidewalk. I'm expecting
The photo on the left, of course, is New York, naked protester. The photo on the right is Canada, the G20 event last year, with Officer Bubbles. Here's some additional New York footage that I caught her in that she didn't really expect that she was being filmed, so she tries to cover her face. We'll visit her Facebook page to find out who she really is in a moment, but first let's take a look at the other one that was involved with that incident that day.
A YouTube video showing a confrontation between a G20 protester and an officer has gone viral and is making...
Again, we see another Greenberg, Tony's sister, Jennifer Sexton.
If the woman touches me, I'm going to be arrested for assault. Do you understand me?
Don't confuse Officer Bubble with the individual that was arrested on the Brooklyn Bridge. Even though they do look alike, their ears don't match, so they aren't the same person. This is the protester that was blowing the bubbles that got arrested. Does she appear in a New York event? She sure does. With her partner from the pepper spray incident and from the G20. Right there behind her. Now, in addition to these girls, we also see that the individuals that were arrested at the G20, along with them, also appear in the New York Occupied pepper spray event. These two. Let's look at this video again, and we will see some additional actors that appear in the New York Occupied as well as the G20. And one individual in here actually appears in the Dallas Occupied as well, and he is an moveon.org member. Here's one, the so-called lawyer, the one in the blue shirt here. Toronto? New York. Toronto, New York, Dallas, and move on.
We're willing to stand up and fight, and we gave hell to the ones who.
Toronto, New York, and you may remember her as in part one, the Virginia Tech shooting student.
Instead of his name, Sarah Stevens is a junior here at Virginia Tech and a former CBS News intern. She and Sho were in the same playwriting class.
The person on Millionaire Matchmaker.
I'm a really good mom to my two Pomeranians, Bruiser and Paris Hilton. They're just like the light of my life.
JC Dugard and the person on that got beat up by TSA.
Jail after a routine airport security check.
He slams my head against the table. My God, I'm getting beaten up.
She is mad as hell and she's going...
As well as she is a Dave Vice associate. Now let's take a look at some of the actors that play multiple roles in different cities. Toronto. New York. We have the actor Paula Rhodes playing an activist in New York at the Occupy Movement. Emma McMahon at the Tucson Loeffner event. Amy at the Washington, D.C. Occupied. And then another activist at Occupied in New York. And then we also have the MoveOn.org employee playing police. And then returning the following day to play protester.
On Saturday, July 16th, roughly 60 people gathered in front of the provincial legislature to blow bubbles. Valentino Nisco helped organize the event.
Just because I thought people needed some place to get together and have fun.
Intelligent. He would help me out with like my math. He would, you know, and that's how it started off. He just kind of seemed like one of those kids that kind of kept to himself. He was very, very quiet. I kind of made the effort to talk to him because he kind of kept to himself, and he was actually a really nice kid when it came, you know, because we ended up dating like probably I think I had just turned 15.
And who could forget Tony Greenberg, Toronto. I received a